I'm Dinesh Kumar. I'm MD of AP SAPNET. I'll just quickly glance through the digital infrastructure available in AP and what are the other activities AP Fiber is undertaking. So to start with, the vision statement of the Andhra Pradesh, we totally aligned to the vision 2029 to make the state best among the entire nation and as well as in the world by 2050. By providing the digital infrastructures, connecting every home and enabling the households to really participate in the digital revolutions to come. And we are one of the five grids of government of AP giving the fiber infrastructure, and we are the partners of seven missions and five campaigns undertook by the government of AP here. And our vision is to connect every home with an affordable and non-discriminatory access to the internet of minimum 15 Mbps of bandwidth to the households and 100 Mbps to the enterprises, including the government institutions as well. That is to be done by 2018-19, and we are on the job. This is done, this entire infrastructure which we are planning to establish is to reach out to the pinnacle of our governance. So our mantra is connect, digitize, and govern. So we are going to be the backbone for the connectivity point of view through AP Fiber, and through these connections, we're going to digitize the entire governance structures, right from the Anganwadis to the Secretariat, with all these applications and governance through this backbone of connectivity. And third is the governance. And our Honorable CM's mantra of revolutionizing the governance is through real-time governance. So real-time governance can only be possible through real-time connectivity, which is sharing the dynamic data for supporting any kind of decisions in the governance as well. So as I was telling, we are taking care of the connect, and the second E-Pragati, I think you had a discussion with E-Pragati for digitizing, and the RTG for the governance. So how this idea came, and what is the uniqueness of this particular project? AP Fiber came out of idea of the Honorable CM to connect every households, to give a backbone of trunk infrastructure of some 23,700 kilometers of fiber. Just we are piggybacking on the existing electrical poles, which was connected in a record time of 9 months. And we have today 2,554 POPs, points of presence in every substations. So from there, the last mile connectivity has been taken care of the local cable operators and multi-signal operators. So that's a uniqueness of this particular project. And we have our total network of 55% in ring architecture and another 45% in SPAR, which we are going to increase to 95% through Government of India project of Bharat Broadband Network Limited, where another 51,000 kilometers of trunk fiber is going to be added, which is up to the Gram Panchayat level. And I'll just quickly run through the roadmap where we came from. Our 24,000 kilometers in 9 months, well, the concept of 24,000 kilometers of keeping our POPs in 2,500 locations is to reach out to every GPs. We have 12,960 Gram Panchayats, out of which 85% of these Gram Panchayats are under the reach of 5 kilometers with this particular trunk and POPs availability. And we took up a unique technology of IPM PLS running on DWDMs with the GPON technology. We have 24 core OFCs reaching out to all these substations from which the last mile is being taken out. And we have a capacity now enhanced up to catering 12 million households in the future to come. So now we have a unique technology of triple play in a multicast model. We have a voice through it. We had also a telecom company of unified license holders of through voice and data through high-speed internet of minimum 15 Mbps to the households and 100 Mbps to the enterprises, and video. We also give IPTV. We have a head-ends of IPTV giving at least 320 channels to the households in a single pipe unified through this IPM PLS technology. And we already connected around 5,24,000 total connections in AP, of which 500,015 are households, and rest are the educational institutions, in which includes schools, colleges, government offices and other government enterprises as well. Yeah, this is an infrastructure what we have in a ring format. This is uniquely, I mean, this is state of the art design by the government of AP for following the power infrastructure which is already installed. So we have four different tiers in which it starts with the state, then it comes to the district rings, then we have a zonal ring with DWDM technology and the mandal ring. Coming to, down to the POPs at the substations.
Dinesh, sorry to interrupt you. Yes, actually, since we have many startups in the technology area.
Yes, sir.
Maybe if you can articulate how AP Fiber is going to be useful. For example, I have a startup company, I want to start here. How you are able to provide gigabit bandwidth to them? In fact, for some of the companies, our Honorable Chief Minister says we can even give 1 year free the data connectivity, assured data bandwidth and high quality data bandwidth. And similarly, if you're introducing any new technologies in the AP fiber, whether these new technologies will be an opportunity for some of the startups can come and talk to you and whether they have any better solutions so that you can actually improve the efficiencies or whatever it is. So what are those opportunities for a startup's point of view? Sorry to, because we have got already only 20 minutes are left for the rest of the discussions. Sorry to interrupt you, but
sure,
you can probably articulate on those lines.
Absolutely, sir. So this is one point, this is a, I mean, which I will tell, this is going to be the core of the total infrastructure which we are having. So we have three different headends, like we have IPTV, we have telephone and high speed internet. So like this particular infrastructure is unique in the sense every households are going to be connected with a telephone as well as the high speed internet. So this is going to be the mantra, like for example, if you take a e-commerce, this is the era of e-commerce at the households. It's not the traditional merchandise doesn't work now. With all the startups which grown big like Flipkart, Amazon, whatever, it's banking upon the connectivity to the customers at the endpoint, not at the merchandise. So this particular connectivity to the households where you have a telephone access as well as the internet is going to do wonders, especially for the e-commerce point of view. And our reliable connectivity to the households at 15 Mbps minimum can definitely cater to the coming era of 5G and other digital revolution of data. So these two enablers definitely is going to be a kind of a facilitating environment for any kind of startups to connect to the direct customers. And our point of, as we are providing the digital infrastructures down at the last mile to connecting homes, that any kind of, startups who are having a lineage to have access to the households is going to be a cakewalk here afterwards. So this particular infrastructure, we would like to have e-commerce stuff. We have a distributed call centers. We can use the households for your distributed BPO services, KPO services, where you don't need any premises to assemble them, as well as you have a reliable connectivity at 99.99 uptime. So that is going to be one important task which I just wanted to highlight in this particular slide, where we have a reliable connectivity with
Dinesh, you can also give some data on the cost of providing this bandwidth.
Yes, sir.
Because many startups and companies, bandwidth is one infrastructure which is a costly infrastructure for them.
Yes, sir.
So there also, how cost effective is our AP fiber bandwidth to these technology companies? Maybe if you can give that number also in US dollars, that will be more useful for them.
So we have connected households with all the three triple play services with less than $3. It's 149 in Indian rupees with all these three connectivity to the households.
Keep
and for the enterprises, closer, especially at the 100 Mbps, and we have our lease line secured digital infrastructure to the enterprises at the rate of 1200 rupees for a month. So which is going to be a kind of a $20 or $20 a month. So this reliable connectivity definitely would be a boost for any kind of a startup who is going to start and engaging, especially to tap the resources, the potentials at the household level. So this is the entire roadmap and entire infrastructure which we have at the different doorsteps. And we have a strength at the last mile, because connecting to the households is the key mantra right now, which whosoever connected to the households is going to reap the benefit of the digital revolution. Because digital revolution doesn't end up in enterprises. It starts and it's a beginning with the households, which we are trying to achieve. Some.
See, a lot of startups here, they want to do the tele-education, telemedicine applications, maybe tele-agriculture. How AP Fiber going to every home up to gigabits of bandwidth? How, I mean, the entrepreneurs can think of providing some innovative solutions in those three, four areas, I mean, whatever I just articulated. Okay, maybe Vijayanand Garu is going to...
Yes, sir. So I'll just stop here for giving a connectivity and the application point. We already have different projects.
Okay.
I'll just go through the projects which we already started. So we have connected 4,000 schools, where the schools are connected in a virtual classroom setup, where there is a curated content and the academic sessions are going live through a controlled environment. We have studios and other stuff, number one. Number two, we have a cloud-based surveillance systems which we connected all around 20,000 cameras coming to the RTG and other stuff. And we have we have Drones Corporation and Content Corporation as well, where we provide drones services for agriculture, mining, and other project management. And we have established a content corporations where we have a content management systems where we go to collect information, curate it, and put it to the public or any enterprises for the access, no,
content,
public access. Well.
Content corporation, I'm coming to that.
Yes.
See, yesterday everybody was telling data is the new oil. When you're creating so much of content, will that be opportunities for the startups? Because so much of terabits of the good quality content you're going to create through the AP Content Corporation. Will that be an opportunity for somebody to take the content, maybe come with a new data sets, new analytics, or whatever they want to do? Do you think, there's an opportunity if some of the companies who are in that business, do you think, they can come and meet you and explore the opportunities?
Absolutely, sir.
Okay.
So we're going to keep the content with various sectors. In fact, the largest content repository is with government. For example, to say health, if we say the lines of health, the vulnerable regions of different particular epidemics, what are the patterns of disease patterns, and what are the potentials of pharma companies to come and invest their research centers to manufacture and supply a kind of medicines which will directly impact the vulnerable regions, which definitely can be provided from the data repository where we are going to collect. And we are going to give access to the enterprises to work on the data as well, because as you rightly pointed out, the data is going to be the gold mine in future, where any kind of a startup or even the government decision is going to be based on the data. So we're going to keep, we're going to have this content corporation as a nodal agency for providing and giving access to the enterprises as well for their commercial as well as the governance interest.
Excellent, Dinesh. Thanks a lot for excellent presentation. I think the content is going to be gold mine for many startups who come from different parts of the globe. I think we have curated content, good quality content. It is up to you what you can use the content and provide new solutions as an opportunity for you. Thank you so much.